Hello. Is it possible to make a very personal work of art by replicating others? Well, if you see the work of the American conceptual artist Sturtevant, you can only say yes. Sturtevant has repeated works by stars in the art market like Warhol, Duchamp and Stella, often well before they became famous. Now, an exhibition at Paris's Modern Art Museum features a selection of her most important works, as well as some new ones. And I'm delighted to say Elaine Sturtevant joins us now. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to France 24.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, there are two parts of this exhibition, the Razzle Dazzle of Thinking. There's Wild to Wild and my favourite, the House of Horrors. Talk us through the exhibition for those people who haven't had a chance to go and see it. What can they expect to see there?
What can they expect to see? You mean when they go from Wild to Wild to the House of Horror? Well, the Wild to Wild is more about image over image, which is what we're about now in our cybernetic world. And so it has more space in terms of triggering thinking, and it brings you back to yourself. And it had to be in exact opposition to the other exhibition. So when I was devising the other part, I knew that it had to be very different. So then House of Horror seemed like a good idea. So the House of Horror is really, it's just entertainment. But the nice thing is that Wild had the ability to give it the force of opposition. So that brings it up to a higher level. So that's very nice. It's very good.
And I noticed when I was there, there's even parents bringing their kids to go and have a go on the ghost train in the House of Horrors. Is that the kind of thing you wanted? Or?
Oh, we knew. I mean, this this was not done without closed eyes. No, of course, we also, I anticipated people would be more attracted to the House of Horror than the Wild to Wild. People don't really like to think or reflect. So entertainment, of course, is super. You know, and so then that's also the cybernetic part of the exhibition. Yeah.
Now, you are an artist really like no other. I read one critic say, you copy artwork, but you're not a copyist. You are a renegade female artist, but you're not a feminist.
That's right.
What do you see yourself as?
I see myself as a very strong woman. And, with a lot of force, a lot of power, and a total enchantment and love of living, of being. Yes, that's how I see myself.
Now, a few decades ago, I won't go into how many, but you decided to start replicating, if that's what you call it, I'm not sure, other people's work.
Mm-hmm.
Why and when did you decide to do that?
Oh, that was quite some time ago. That was when in the early 60s. And at that time, everything was very surface. Like we had and the abstract expressionists were just burning out then. And then we had pop art, which was the very top. So both those movements are very all about surface. All right. So having been sort of embedded in that, I mean, surrounded by it, it became clear that I had to, that one would want to think about the understructure of art. So that's how I came into it.
And you were quite ahead of your time because lots of the work that you replicated, it was done by quite unknown artists who later went on to become sort of superstars, didn't they? How did you have such a good vision? Was it just a coincidence or?
Oh, it's never a coincidence. No, it never happens as a coincidence. It's, I think it was about having distance from the self. And so then you have the ability to see what's going on and what will go on. Yeah.
So what are you trying to say with your works, with your art?
Oh, my God, you want to come to the seminar?
In a minute, if you can sum it up in a minute.
In a minute. I'm talking about cybernetics intrusion, which includes its digital underling. I'm talking about the imposition that our cybernetic world is now imposing on us, in our life, in our being, in our food, in our way of in every way. And so then that also impinges on the art world and what you have as art today.
Briefly. What do you think about work like Andy Warhol's that people automatically recognize and they associate something with it? What do you think? Is that sort of art good?
Well, you have to, for this work to function, you have to know the artist. See, you'd have to know Warhol. When you look at one of my 10-foot flowers, then you have to know Warhol, because otherwise it doesn't function. Otherwise it'd just be Sturtevant doing a 10-foot flower.
Okay, well, I'm sorry to say we're out of time, but thank you very much.
Thank you.
For coming
it's been
and
a pleasure.
To us. And the Razzle Dazzle of Thinking, the exhibition at the Musée d'Art Moderne de la Ville in Paris, is on until the 25th of April.